Welcome to Easy Higher Mathematics.
Let us start the proof.
Cauchy's integral formula, let f of z be an analytic function. Analytic function inside. In and on a closed contour C, taken in the positive sense if a is a point interior to C, then integral over C f of z d z by z minus a equal to 2 pi I into f of a. So this is the Cauchy's integral formula. So let f of z be an analytic function in and on a closed contour C taken in the positive sense, that is in the positive direction. If a is a point interior to C, then integral over C f of z dz by z minus a is equal to 2 pi I into f of a. So here, what is the condition given? F of z be an analytic function. What is the definition for analytic function? Or what is the meaning of analytic function? Analytic function is on a closed curve C, means it is differentiable at every point inside or on C. So f of z is differentiable at every point on C. So now we have to prove this one. So given proof. Given f of z is analytic. Given f of z is analytic inside and on C. Let A be a point interior to C. Therefore, f of z by z minus A is analytic except at A in C. So what is closed curve? You take this one. This is an axis. So we can take, this is a closed curve. This is a closed curve. So we take one point here that is equal to A. At this point, the whole function is f of z by z minus a is not analytic. Therefore, a is a singular point. A is a singular point. Since it is not analytic at the point A is a singular point. So, since this is a singular point, we can take one small circle around this A. And its radius is equal to R. That is a very small radius. So, now around this point A, around this point A, we make one circle. So, what is this condition? What about this area? So, in this area, the whole function is analytic because this only one point at which the function f of z z minus a is not analytic. So we just covered with an open ball or we can take a small circle around that a. So in between this circle and this area, the whole function is analytic. Therefore, A is a singular point. Let C1 be a circle. Center at A and center at A with a small radius, small radius R. So what's the meaning? That is modulus z minus a, modulus z minus a equal to modulus z minus a is equal to r. This is the equation of the circle because we take it as this is fully circle. So modulus z minus a equal to r by r. This can be written as z is equal to r z minus a is equal to r e power I theta. Therefore, z is equal to a plus r e power I theta. So now you take this is equation number one. So by Cauchy's extension theorem, extension theorem, integral over C f of z by z minus a dz is equal to integral over c1 f of z by z minus a dz. That's the theorem. So c means this whole thing, c1 means this small circle. Now you take this is equation number 2. So integral over c1 we take, for that z minus a equal to what? R e power I theta. Z is equal to a plus r e power I theta. So all these things we can substitute in this equation. So that is now integral over c1, or we can write here also dz is equal to r e power I theta into I d theta, because a differentiation is 0, r is a constant, e raised to I theta differentiation, e raised to I theta, again I theta differentiation I into d theta, and theta varies from theta varies from 0 to pi, because this is a full circle, so angle 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so angle 0 to 2 pi, starting this, so here 0, total 2 pi, so 0 to 2 pi, here also we take the direction is important, so here also 0 to 2 pi. So now integral over c1, f of z by z minus a, dz is equal to, substitute all the things. Now we are going to convert everything to theta. So that is theta is equal to 0 to 2 pi. F of z, what is z? Z is equal to a plus r e power I theta. Then z minus a is equal to r e power I theta. And dz is equal to, dz is r e power I theta into d theta. Now, this e power I theta, this everything cancel, r also cancel. So that is equal to integral 0 to 2 pi f of a plus r e power I theta into I. There is one I also because I. I d theta. So here on I into d theta. Now with a small radius r. Now with a small radius r. So as r tends to zero, what will be this equation? As r tends to r, r tends to not r, r tends to zero. A plus r e power I theta equal to e. Okay. So we can write one more term as r tends to zero. A plus r e power I theta tends to a. Therefore, integral 0 to 2 pi f of a plus r e power I theta I d theta equal to integral 0 to 2 pi. What is f of a plus r e power I theta? This value tends to a. That is equal to f of a I d theta. So that is equal to I into f of a into integral 0 to 2 pi d theta. So that is equal to I into f of a into theta. So that is I into 2 pi into f of a. So that is 2 pi I into f of a. What is this value? This value is integral over C1. That is integral over C1 f of z by z minus a dz is equal to 2 pi I f of a. But 1 implies, sorry, 2 implies, what is 2? Equation number 2 implies integral over C1 f of z by z minus a is equal to what? Integral over C. Integral over C f of z by z minus a dz is equal to 2 pi I into f of a. So this is our required answer. So once again we this is the theorem. Let f of z be analytic in a region D bounded by two concentric circles C1 and C2. And on the boundary, let z not be any point in D, then f of z not equal to 1 by 2 pi I into integral f of z by z minus z not dz minus this one. So what is actual meaning is, this is C1, that is a big circle, and C2 is the small circle. This theorem saying that this f of z naught is equal to 1 by 2 pi I over this big circle minus over the small circle. So that is the theorem. So f of z naught is equal to 1 by 2 pi I integral over C1 f of z by z minus z naught dz minus integral over C2 f of z by z minus z not dz, that is over this big circle minus over the smaller circle. So for the sum constructions by using this figure, let L1 and L2 be the two line segment not passing through z not. So these L1 and L2 are two line segment connecting these two circles. And this divides the region D into two simply connected regions. So one region is this one. This one region. Another is this one. So that is D1 and D2. D1 and D2. This is simply connected. That means connection from here. Connection from here. So this way this is also a simply connected region. Also from this point to this way to this way, then this way. So this is also a simply connected region D1 and D2. Let B1 and B2 be the oriented boundary of D1 and D2. Oriented boundary. So this is the oriented boundary of this D1. D1 boundary is this one and this one. Then let B1, okay, respectively. Then B1 plus B2 is equal to C1 minus C2. So let us see. Oriented boundary means this full segment. But starting from this point, and this point, we start from here. So moving to this area, again this area, this area, this area, this section, and also starting from here, this one. So what is actually meaning of this? What is this area actually? That is the annular region. That is the total C1 minus C2. C1 minus C2 is the this region. This region is sum of two regions D1 and D2. Its oriented region is equal to B1 and B2. So meaning is, if you subtract C1 from, sorry, subtract C2. If you subtract C2 from C1, you can get this region. Okay. If you subtract C2 from C1, you can get this region. So now that is divided into two regions, B1 and B2. So this section plus this section is equal to whole C1 minus this C2. So you can get this one. So that is the explanation. That is then B1 plus B2 is equal to C1 minus C2. Now, without loss of generality, and we can write there, without the loss of generality, we assume that Z0 belongs to this either D1 or D2. We take D1. Therefore, by Cauchy's integral formula, integral over, that is integral over B1, f of z by z minus z naught equal to f of z naught, given by 2 pi I. Also, f of z by z minus z naught analytic in B2. Because if you take this one, this is where B1, this is B1, we take here z naught. So, as in the previous theorem, Cauchy's integral theorem, we take some circle, smallest circle, etc., etc., we derived this one. But in this D2, this is not lies in this D2. Therefore, also f of z by z not analytic in B2. So, analytic in B2. Therefore, by Cauchy's integral theorem, integral over B2 f of z by z minus z naught given dz equal to 0. If this point lies inside, then only we can get f of z naught. If the point lies outside, that value is equal to 0. Therefore, adding this, we take this is equation number 1. So this is equation number 2. So 1 plus 2 implies 1 by 2 pi I integral over b1 f of z0 by z minus z0 dz is equal plus or plus integral over 1 by 2 pi I 1 by 2 pi I integral over b2 f of z0 by z minus z0 dz is equal to f of z0 f of z0 plus 0, that is equal to f of z0. So this is equal to what? That is equal to 1 by 2 pi I integral b1 plus b2 integral b1 plus b2 f of z0 by f of z0 f of z by z minus z0 dz is equal to f of z0. But here b1 plus b2 is equal to c1 minus c2. So b1 plus b2 is equal to c1 minus c2. That is equal to, since or you take this is equation number, this is equation number capital 1. 1 capital 1 implies 1 by 2 pi y from capital 1. That is better. From capital 1, 1 by 2 pi I integral c1 minus c2 f of z by z minus z0 dz is equal to f of z0. That is equal to 1 by 2 pi I, we can separate f of z by z minus z0 dz minus 1 by 2 pi I integral c2 f of z by z minus z0 dz. That is equal to f of z0. So this is